Praise the Lord. Greetings to you in Jesus' name. Hope you all are doing good by God's grace. People often say, this is my life, my style, my attitude. I can live as I like. But I want to remind you that when you work in a company, you don't say that this is my job, my life, I can do as I like. You will follow the rules and you will follow the terms and conditions. Then only you can stay in that company and you can work for it. And knowing that we are a child of God and we are fearfully, wonderfully created in the image of God and we are purchased through the blood of Jesus Christ, how can you say that this is my life and my style, my attitude, I can live as I like? Word of God says in Isaiah chapter 43 verse 21, it says that these people whom I have formed for myself shall declare my praise. Yes, we are not belongs to our own, we belong to God. And here word of God says, these people whom I have formed for myself should declare the glory, should declare the praise. We are here to praise God. Yes, we should know that we are not our own, we belong to God and we are here to praise God. And same chapter 7 verse, it says that everyone who is called by my name, whom I have created for my glory. Yes, we are created to glorify God in this world. We have to know that, we have to know that, and we are not belongs to our own. We are here on this planet to praise Him, to glorify Him. Isaiah chapter 45 verse 12, it says that, I have made the earth and created man on it. I, my hand, stretched out the heavens and all their host I have commanded. Whatever you see in this universe, just created by God. Yes. We have to know that. We have to know that. Only one thing we have to know that. And we are here to praise God, to glorify God. Whatever you see in this world, in this universe, is created by God. Yes, in Colossians chapter 1 verse 16, it says that, for by Him all things were created, that are in heaven and that are on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created through Him and for Him. Yes, whatever you see in this universe, everything was created through Him and for Him. Yes, in John chapter 1 verse 3, it says that, all things were made through Him and without Him nothing was made that was made. Without God, nothing was made. Yes. Everything was made by God, and even you, yes, we are made by God and created by God. So we are so precious in the sight of God. Everything in this universe, everything in this creature, nature, everything listen to God and obeys to the word of God, obeys the voice of God. By the man whom God loved the most, today he went away from God. He says that this is my life, my style, my attitude. So how can it be fair, my friends? We have to know that. Yes, word of God says that, Proverbs chapter 3 verse 6, it says that, in all your ways acknowledge Him. Yes, in all our ways we have to acknowledge God. We have before you start any work, you should know that, you should think, and this question should be in your mind that, through this work can I bring glory to God? Through this work can I praise God? Through this work can the name of God can be glorified? These questions should be in our mind. Today so many people live their life as they like. They doesn't matter what the word of God says and how they should live their life. They don't matter. They became one among the worldly people. But here word of God says that in all your ways acknowledge God. Yes, we are not by our own. We belong to God. We are created for His glory and we are created for His praise. So we have to know. We have to know why we are in this planet. What is the purpose I am here? We have to know. Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 23, he says that all things are legitimate for me, but all things are not profitable. Yeah, you have permission to anything, but you should know that as a child of God, if you do certain things, through the things what you are doing, through that God's names glorifies or not, you have to remember that, you have to know that. Everything you can do, nobody will stop you from doing what you deserve. But you yourself should think that through this can I bring glory to God. We have to know and we have to know. So and the word of God says that, but not all things edifies. You can do so many things, you can do as you desire, but all the those things, you cannot edify your family member, and you cannot edify your fellow member, you cannot edify your friends, you cannot edify your family. But you have to choose and select what can edify your family member and what can bring glory to God. That is your work as a child of God. You have to remember the things what you need to do that. Yes, my dear friends, Word of God says that in Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 5, it says that love your God with all your strength, with all your soul, with all your might. Yes, we have to love our God. If you love God with all your strength, with all your soul, you will just stop before doing anything and you will just think whether it can bring glory to God or not. Yes, we have to know that. And main thing, we have to know why you are here on this planet. Yes. First of all, Ephesians chapter 1 verse 4, it said that we are created to be holy. We are created to be holy. Yes, we have to keep ourselves holy. It's a way, nowadays very difficult for people to keep themselves holy, because everywhere, even if you use mobile, so many things are coming. Even if you don't go to that website also, you can see so many bad pictures. So how can we keep ourselves holy? By reading the Word of God, by listening the Word of God. You have to know the purpose. You are here to keep yourself holy. Yes, we have to keep ourselves holy. Only by the Word of God, by the fear of God only, we can keep ourselves holy, my dear friends. And the same Ephesians chapter 2 verse 10, it says that we are created to do good things. Yes, many times we think by doing good things, we don't get anything. Why should I do? Even though situations are like that, we should learn to do good things. Yes, we have to know that we are created. We are created by God's image. We are here to be holy and we are here to do good things. Yes, no matter you will get benefit or not, but you have to do good things. We have to know that one. And Matthew chapter 5, 16, it says that let your light shine before the people. The light which you receive from Jesus Christ, that should shine before the people. People who sees you, they should not see you, but they should see Christ in you. That should be your attitude. Your life should shine before the people. Your attitude, your style, the way of life should shine before the people. And they should get something. Your life should be helpful. Your life should edify the people. That's what Bible says. Today, people learn so many things by seeing other people. So if you are a child of God, if you live like one among the worldly people, how people can be helpful through your life? We have to remember, you have to think. Through your life, people should edify themselves. People should draw themselves closer to God. That is the way you should live in this world, my dear brothers and sisters. You are here with a great purpose. You should never forget the purpose you are here on this planet. Yes, that's very important. We are pilgrims and one day we are going back to our Father. And we have to tell what we have done in this world and how we live for Christ's sake. That is very, very important. And 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 9, it says to have fellowship with Him. We are here with the purpose that we should have fellowship with God. If you go out of station, you call your mom, dad and you say, Mom, I'm here, I'm there. You will give information to your parents. The same way you have to connect with God each and every second of your life. Every moment you should have connect with God. You should speak with God. You should spend time with God. Then only your life, you and God will have fellowship. You will have fellowship with God. Fellowship with God is very, very important to keep our life holy and pure from this world, my dear brothers and sisters. Do you have fellowship with God? Do you spend time with God? That's very important. And one more thing, and Ephesians chapter 3 verse 8 to 10, it says that what church taught us. We learn so many things in the church that you should reveal to the unbelievers. You should reveal to your friends. You should express the love of God. You should preach the word of God. You should tell the love of God what you receive from the Christ. That's the purpose you are here. You have to know that. And when you read Hebrews chapter 12 verse 9, we read here 12:9, it says, furthermore, we have had human fathers who corrected us and we paid them respect. Shall we not much more readily be in subject to the heavenly Father of spirit and life? Yes, You obey your father. You love your dad so much, your mother so much, and you love them and you obey them. How much more we have to obey our Heavenly Father? Yes, many times we live for the people's sake. We should not be like that. We should know that we are here on this planet with the purpose that to bring glory to God, to praise God, to love Him, to keep ourselves holy. And if you obey your earthly father, it's important to obey our Heavenly Father much more than our earthly father. Yes, you may have questions. Even though I live like that, and if I live according to how you said, I get so many problems, I became a loser. But it doesn't matter. Word of God says in 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 16, it says that if anyone suffers as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God in this matter. If you follow all these things and if you suffer, praise God. You have to praise God, because word of God says, for good sake, if you suffer, that will be a blessing for you, and you can bring glory to God through your suffering. If you can bring glory to God through your suffering, let us suffer for Christ, my dear friends. Yes. So out of all these things, we have to remember you are here on this planet with a great purpose, that is to keep yourself holy and to do good things, to shine yourself for God, and also to have fellowship with Him, to reveal the love of God. Yes, even you do all these things, surely the life which you live on this planet will have great meanings. And finally, one thing I want to tell and conclude, that in Ecclesiastes 12 chapter 13 verse, it says that what is the duty of man? To fearing God and keeping His commandments. Yes, we are here with a great purpose. Let us fear unto God. Let us follow His commandments. Let us love God with all our strength, with all our soul, with all our heart, so that we can bring glory to God. May God bless you all. Amen.